गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू अ सोशल स्टडी क्लास. टुडे आई विल कंटिन्यू द सेम लेसन, सेफ्टी एंड फर्स्ट एड, पेज नंबर 62. टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट फर्स्ट एड. चिल्ड्रन, डू यू नो व्हाट इज फर्स्ट एड? फर्स्ट एड इज द इमीडिएट हेल्प गिवन टू द इंजर्ड और सिक पर्सन बिफोर डॉक्टर अराइव्स. Always follow these first aid rules. First point is send someone for a doctor immediately. Means we should call a doctor at once. Second point is do not get panicky. Means do not get frightened for sudden accident. Third point is do not crowd around a person who is injured. We should not gather near the injured person or sick person. Fourth point is, if the injured person is bleeding, try to stop the bleeding with the clean cotton or cloth pad. Means, stop the bleeding on priority with a clean cotton or cloth pad. Fifth point is, once the bleeding stops, clean the wound with an antiseptic and bandage it. Never leave a wound exposed. So children, the wound should be kept clean and never leave the wound open. Now the sixth point is, if a person has fainted, rest his head lower than his body. It helps to increase the supply of blood to the brain. Children, suppose a person is fainted, we should keep his head or her head lower than his body. It increases blood flow to the brain. Now the seventh point is, in case of a burn, pour some clean cold water on the affected area or apply some ice. Apply some antiseptic cream with the pad of cotton. If the burn is severe, take the patient to the doctor. Children, if you get burn, pour some cold water or apply some ice and apply some antiseptic cream with a pad of cotton. If the person is badly burned, take him or her to the doctor. Now the eighth point is, insect bite can be harmful. Wash the affected spot with lime water, place ice over the affected spot, apply an antiseptic cream on the affected area. So students, if the insects bite you, wash the affected spot with the lime water, then apply an antiseptic cream. And last of all, we should always keep a first aid kit handy. Now, we will learn about good touch or bad touch. First of all, good touch. If a person whom you know or trust hugs you or touches you, makes you feel safe and comfortable, such type of touches are known as good touch. Gestures of good touch are parents hug and kiss, grandparents love, teacher pats you on the head, brief friendly hugs by family members, shaking hands or giving high five doesn't make you feel bad. Here, I want to give you an example. When you win a medal in a competition, your principal gives you the medal and pats you on the shoulder. She appreciates you. This shows good touch. Bad touch. If a person whom you do not know or trust hugs you or touches you, you may not feel good. It makes you uncomfortable or angry. Such touches are known as bad touch. Gestures of bad touch are touching the back, kissing on the mouth, told to keep it secret, hitting, slapping, spitting, pushing or punching. Touch that makes you feel scared and nervous. An example of bad touch. Students, keep in mind that if an unknown person touches you in a bad or in an uncomfortable way and tells you to keep it a secret, then you should tell about that bad touch to your parents, grandparents, teachers, or any adult whom you know and trust. Students, now the explanation of this chapter is completed. In the next period, we will continue with the exercises. Have a good day.